One other country that's toying around with the idea of an official digital currency is Ghana. Our reporter Nabil Ahmed Rufai brings us a closer look at the opportunities and the risks their government faces in embracing cryptocurrency.
Nick Owusu trades in cryptocurrency. He uses Bitcoin for online transactions such as money transfers and investments.
You are able to receive money and send money digitally anywhere in the world. And it's very fast, it's very convenient, and it's very cheap.
Even though it's illegal in Ghana, Owusu has used Bitcoin for trading for more than 6 years. He says it comes with some risks when used for investments.
If the demand for Bitcoin goes up, the value also goes up. If the demand for Bitcoin reduces, the value goes down. So if you are using it as a means of storing value, that is the only time you are exposed to these fluctuations in price.
While there is a growing trend among Ghanaians trading in cryptocurrency, the central bank says it is illegal because it is unregulated. The government has warned people to stop trading with cryptocurrency.
When you have a currency whose value is so unstable, really, you really cannot use it effectively to meet any of the standard functions of money. And this is why I think there's a lot more emphasis on looking at digital money, which is backed by the state, backed by the central banks.
In September, Ghana's central bank began a pilot of a digital currency, e-cedi, that it wants to introduce into the economy.
People from different parts of the country and socioeconomic backgrounds have been selected to test the e-cedi on mobile phone apps and smart cards. The central bank says the pilot phase will determine whether it's safe to release the digital currency on a broader scale for transactions.
Analysts say more needs to be done to make it easy for Ghanaians to accept the e-cedi for financial services.
The threat, it's about the hackers and then the fraudulent, you know, actors. So if you are able to handle them, then there will be a smooth running of operations with regard to the e-cedi.
Last year, cryptocurrency transfers to and from Africa reached more than $300 million, with Nigeria, South Africa and Kenya doing most of the transactions. Analysts do not want Ghana's central bank to rule out trading in cryptocurrency entirely, but rather find ways of regulating it. Nick Owusu says trading in cryptocurrency will continue in Ghana despite the warnings against it, and strongly believes if it is regulated, Ghana's economy will benefit. Nabil Ahmed Rufai, for Newsy, Accra, Ghana.